Okay, let me start by introducing you to the equipments of the collaborative design. Okay, as you all are very familiar with, we have the projector, PC, all that, right? This is the before the collaborative design. So the traditional classroom setting, you will have all this. This part, I think you all are quite familiar. So we'll move on to the collaborative design. So we have added 4 LCD panels at the side, okay, including this collaborative. this table is specially designed for group discussion because they are sitting in the circle, and also the whiteboard for the student to do write as they do discussion. Basically. These are the few features for the collaborative designs. Okay, next one, for visualizer, okay, just to go through quickly, okay, when you press the document cam here, the visualizer will turn on itself, okay? And most of the lecturers who don't know that we can do, something like this, okay? So you. Normally, when you all use the visualizer, you all stand here, okay? But you all, this visualizer, you can rotate, okay? So instead of standing here, you can move to the front, okay? So when you talk, you can move around. Then you just need to come back here and point back to stuff. Then you can also zoom in. Not yet rotate, sorry. Okay, so once you rotate, right, you at any angle you can teach. So this one is some of the function. And you also can zoom in. Okay, zoom in to show make the words bigger. Okay. Okay, so actually we prepare a few slides. We came up with a few configurations. So this is the traditional way of presenting. So the next one, the group presentation. Next. Okay, for group discussion, right, the students, okay, after you all break into the groups, right, the students can just come over, plug in their laptop. Okay, here you can see PC1 and PC2. So PC2 will always display what the laptop is projecting. Okay. Okay, so something like this. So each individual panels can do this. Dr. Shanti say you can do those gallery view, okay? Something like exhibition. The group can go around to do their own presentation at their site. Okay, so this is one of the feature, one of the way. So another feature is as what the gentleman wanted to know, right? Okay, Casey, can help me switch back. Yeah. To do this, right, you need to press PC1 again. Okay, PC1, okay, basically shows what the main projector is presenting. So, to show, so that you all don't need to come, right? Let me. Okay. So here, right, actually, I don't think you all can see, here there's a LCD button, okay? So as you can see on the panel side, you will see the corresponding number. Okay, so here once you just need to press once on the LCD, okay, and then to the corresponding number. So for example, group 4, he went to sleep. Okay, LCD 3. Okay, LCD 3 is the PC behind. So this is how you do it. So after. Okay. Okay, there will be a LCD button. Okay. Okay, you just click on the press on the LCD button. Okay, after that, on this, let me switch back for you first. So this is the selector lah. You will see these four red buttons. So it's labeled 1, 2, 3, 4. So once you just press, like for example, LCD 2, okay, it will show what LCD 2 is showing. Okay, so to move back to next discussion, okay. Okay, this is the diagram, how it will look like. Okay, lastly, right, okay. Okay, maybe I will use this, switch to PC2, yeah. Okay, so in any lessons that you want to, you have a constant reference point, right, you can always switch use one of the LCD to show them, like, this is reference, like you want to compare between your main screen and another website or something like that. Okay, so this is one of the configuration. Yeah, this is one of the configuration that you can do. As long you don't need all to be showing the main projector. Okay. So if you have any queries later, I will stay back to answer your queries. Or let's say in future, if you need any help, okay, you can email us. We can come down to give you one-on-one demo. Or if you during your lesson you have any issues, you can call the service desk. We will come down. Yeah.